यशोदानन्दन जय जनरंजन यशोदानन्दन जय जनरंजन
सिंह देव की शिशि गौणिताय की श्रील प्रभुपाद की समावेत भक्त बंद की और प्रेम हरि ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय सो वी विल बी रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भगवद गीता एज इट इज एवरीवन हैज अ कॉपी चैप्टर 5 कर्म योग एक्शन इन कृष्ण कॉन्शियसनेस And this is text number 22. So you can please repeat after me. Yehi sansparshaja bhoga. Yehi sansparshaja bhoga. Dukkayo naya evate. दुःखयो नय एव ते आद्यन्तवन्त कौन्तेय आद्यन्तवन्त कौन्तेय न ते शूरमते बुधः ये हि संस्पर्शजा भोगा दुःखयोनय एव ते आद्यन्तवन्त कौन्तेय न ते शूरमते बुधः ये हि संस्पर्शजा भोगा दुःखयोनय एव ते आद्यन्तवन्त कौन्तेय Nate shuramate buddhaha. Yehi sansparshaja bhoga. Dukkayo naya evate. Adhyantavanta kaunteya. Nate shuramate buddhaha. Danyagopi, would you like to chant the verse on the screen? No? Yehi samsparshaja bhoga. Dukkha yonaya evate. Adhyantavanta kaunteya. Nate shuramate buddhaha. Very nice, thank you. Okay, we'll do word for word. Ye, those, he, certainly, sansparshajaha, by contact with the material senses, bhogaha, enjoyments, dukkha, distress, yonayaha, sources of, eva, certainly, te, they are, adi, beginning, anta, end, vantaha, subject to, kaunteya, O son of Kunti, na, never, teshu, in those, ramate, takes delight, buddhaha, the intelligent person. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. An intelligent person does not take part in the sources of misery, which are due to contact with the material senses. O son of Kunti, such pleasures have a beginning and an end, and so the wise man does not delight in them. Okay, please repeat the translation. An intelligent person does not take part in the sources of misery, which are due to contact with the material senses. O son of Kunti, such pleasures have a beginning and an end. So the wise man does not delight in them. Purport. Material sense pleasures are due to the contact of the material senses, which are all temporary because the body itself is temporary. A liberated soul is not interested in anything which is temporary. Knowing well the joys of transcendental pleasures, how can a liberated soul agree to enjoy false pleasure? In the Padma Purana it is said, Ramante yogino nante satyanande chidatmane iti rama padenasau param brahma bhidiyate. The mystics derive unlimited transcendental pleasures from the Absolute Truth. And therefore, the Supreme Absolute Truth, the Personality of Godhead, is also known as Rama. In the Srimad Bhagavatam also, 5.5.1, it is said, Nayam deho deha bhajam ruloke kashtan kama narhate vidbhujam ye tapo divyam putra kayena sattvam shuddhet yasmad brahma saukhyam tvanantam. My dear sons, there is no reason to labor very hard for sense pleasure while in this human form of life. Such pleasures are available to the stool eaters, hogs. Rather, you should undergo penances in this life by which your existence will be purified, and as a result, you will be able to enjoy unlimited transcendental bliss. Therefore, those who are true yogis are learned transcendentalists are not attracted by sense pleasures, which are the causes of continuous material existence. The more one is addicted to material pleasures, the more he is entrapped by material miseries. Umagnanatimirandhasya jnananjana shalakaya chakshurunmilitam yena tasmai shri gurave namaha mukam karoti vachalam pangum langhayate girim yatkripatamaham vande shri gurum dinatarinam paramanandamadhavam shri krishna chaitanyam ishwaram nama om vishnu padaya krishna preshtaya bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Vancha Kalpatarubhyascha Krupasindubhya Evacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare. So I seek the blessings of all the Vaishnavas so that I can speak on this verse and I should be speaking before those who are elders, seniors to me. It's Prabhu here, Jiva Mataji was there. It's Guru Mariyada Vetikrama. So thank for forgiveness. So it's a service given to me. Please give me your blessings. So this is from Karma Yoga, Action in Krishna Consciousness. Very important chapter in the Bhagavad Gita. Krishna, Arjuna asks at the beginning of this chapter, what is better, whether renouncing work or working devotion? And Krishna explains that both will lead you to the path, but working devotion is better than just mere renunciation of work, because eventually the purpose of renunciation is to come to the platform of devotional service. So then in the process of explaining the Karma Yoga, Action in Krishna Consciousness, this verse comes up. What is the vision of a self-realized person, how he sees everything in this world, how he engages in this world. So there are some very important words in this particular verse, as well as two citations, very famous citations as well in the purport. Samsparshaja bhoga, sparsha. What does the word sparsha mean? Touch, contact, right? And we have seen in the very beginning of the Bhagavad Gita, in the second chapter itself, Krishna is telling Arjuna that we are not this body. And Arjuna is feeling bad because his friends, his cousins, his teacher, his uncles, grandfather, everybody, they are assembled on the battlefield of Kurukshetra, and he's worried that they will die, and he's experiencing sorrow. And Krishna explains, it's just the beginning of the verses, he said, you are speaking like a pandita, but actually you don't know. And then he explains, matra sparshastu kaunteya. What does matra sparsha mean? Sense perception, right? We said sparsha means touch, contact. So matra sparsha is the contact of the senses. Shitoshna sukadukkada. Happiness and distress comes by the contact of the senses with the sense objects. And he said it is not permanent, it comes and goes like summer and winter seasons. And was there snow here today a little bit? Yeah, the first day of snow. And my daughter said, better go to temple today. Because you never know whether you get another chance with the snow when you go, you know. Planning to go to India, I don't know if that will happen, but so we have to go to temple today when she saw the snow. The summer and the winter season, we enjoyed, you know, nice weather through the summer and fall, and now winter is coming, we don't like it. right? So, however, Krishna says, in both the situations, a yogi, he learns how to transcend, how to be happy in all the situations. So, sparshaja bhoga. Bhoga means, what is bhoga? Enjoyment. And what we offer to Krishna is also bhoga. Right? When we say, don't look at it, it's bhoga. So, it also is that thing that is meant for enjoyment. And but whose enjoyment? For Krishna's. So therefore it has to be enjoyed by Krishna. Right now Krishna is having bhoga. So he is the true enjoyer. We are meant to partake his remnants. But when we try to enjoy for our own pleasure but not for his service, then that's not good. So therefore it's recommended we should not be bhogis, but we should be yogis. Yogi is the one who is properly connected with Krishna and who does things for Krishna's pleasure. Bhogi is the one who does things for his material enjoyment, but he gets trapped. Why does he get trapped? That's the nature of it. That's why dukkha yonaya evate. And this word, dukkha yoni, literally yoni means the place of birth. This tasam brahma mahadyonir aham bija pradapita. Krishna says, I impregnate this material world with the living entities. So the living entities are taking birth in this material world. So it's like the mother, dukkha yoni, the mother of miseries. What is the mother of miseries? Sparshaja bhoga. That enjoyment that we get by the contact of the senses with the sense objects, Krishna is calling it as the mother of miseries. So that means that very enjoyment that we experience will give birth to something. Beautifully Krishna explains, right? Yes, there is enjoyment, but along the enjoyment there is also birth. One sannyasi showed me a video. His Holiness Badinaran Swami. It's not for grihasthas, I'm sorry, but I'm also a grihastha. So the video is, there's one young girl crying for help. Help me, help me, help me. And there's this hero, he's going on the horse and and he wants to save the lady, and suddenly some lightning and knowledge descends upon him. And he has this visual coming in front of him. And he saved the girl, and then they married, and there were children, and they're all of a sudden he's changing diapers and he's feeding the baby and all that stuff. He's miserable and he screams and he takes the horse in the other direction and runs away. It's a sannyasi video, right? So the material world is, of course, you know, the later Srila Prabhupada explains, Varnashrama Dharma is meant to control this enjoyment so that we can do everything in the service of the Lord. But we have to realize that material enjoyment, yes, there is enjoyment. There are two things. One is it's temporary. It will not continue forever. That's why it says, Adi Antavanta Kaunteya. Adi means beginning, Anta means end. So there's a beginning to it and there's an end to it. And this also, that's one thing. Okay, you know, I want to enjoy. But so then so what? Material energy is so beautiful, so wonderful, amazing. That even though that same thing is frustrating to me, it's attractive to somebody else. Right? Like if you ask older devotees, they're like, I have seen that. You are in your passions, go ahead, right? I know what's going to happen. They'll just smile. All right, keep going, keep going. And there's one time one boy, you know, he thinks his parent doesn't know anything, and he goes and travels, and he becomes a little older. And he, when his dad is speaking, he says, "Dad, you have become wise. Dad didn't become wise. You were a fool before. Now you are recognizing that he's giving you, you know, very valuable suggestions." So this is one thing with the material energy, is whatever is rejected by somebody is appealing to someone else. And not only that, there are so many varieties in the material energy. It gives us so many varieties of enjoyment, so there are unlimited things to try out. If this doesn't work, I'm going to try out something else, something else, something else, something else, something else. And unfortunately, we have been trying for a long time. Long time. So many things we have tried. And, you know, we want to try skiing, but we have been there. A polar bear trying that stuff. We want to fly, but we have been birds. And we come around. And the coming around concept is called punascharvita charvananam. Like chewing the gum. There's nothing in there, but you keep on chewing. Try to extract something out of it. And you become tired, but still we keep on doing it. So sometimes we keep on doing the same things. Sometimes we enjoy things that are rejected by others. Sometimes we keep on trying, keep on trying, keep on trying. So this is the nature of the material world. So yes, we enjoy this way. But then there is some outcome of that enjoyment. And that is the misery that accompanies that enjoyment. And the example of this one is Prahlad Maharaj gives. Kanduyanena karayoriva dukkha dukkham. It's just like itching. When we have itching sensation, we scratch. And then it feels so good. I mean, it's winter time, right? Everybody must have already started experiencing this. It feels so good. You know you shouldn't be doing that, but and then you go in the shower, a little bit hot water, oh my gosh, it burns. So that's the enjoyment, and the pain is the pain has taken birth, dukkha yoni. The misery has come out, has taken birth through that enjoyment. The enjoyment has given birth to the misery. And we can think of so many things. You know, we may want to buy a nice car, and wow, this nice car I'm going to enjoy. And the first problem we run into, we start suffering. Whether you hit the curb, or the first repair comes, then we have a problem. Hare Krishna. So, this enjoyment doesn't last very long. And it gives birth to suffering. So therefore, those who are intelligent, they look for something that is permanent. Permanent enjoyment. Not permanent, not in the sense of a series of, you know, material enjoyments, but a permanent enjoyment. And also, well, we talked about enjoying different things, enjoying the same thing, enjoying something that's rejected by somebody. And there's also the quality of enjoyment. Right? You may experience even humor. Right? Pyari Prabhu is here, and it's humor. There's different grades of humor. There's something class and something mass, particularly in Indian movies. They are categorized, this is a mass movie, means, you know, for someone who has no bigger taste. And some class movies, a little bit, you know, sophisticated humor and sophisticated romance. So even enjoyment, different grades of enjoyment is there. One time Srila Prabhupada was there, and one big man, he walked in and he was talking to Prabhupada. He said, "You know, I have everything. I have lots of money, I'm enjoying, I'm having fun, I have good health. I mean, what's wrong? I'm happy. Why should I take this thing up?" And Srila Prabhupada said, "You know, a hog, a pig, it's also very fat, and it eats stool. I'm sure it must be enjoying, that's why it's eating. And the fact that it's very stout and fat, that means it's happy. So you are happy. The pig, the hog is happy. So what's the difference? And that man thought about it. Yeah, it's also enjoying. So Prabhupada said, this Krishna consciousness, this is higher grade of enjoyment. There's pleasure in this one. That is why this verse cited, now in this verse, there's another word. So we did samsparshaja bhoga, we did dukkha yonaya, we did adi anta. Nateshu ramate buddha. Buddha means intelligent person. Buddha, buddhi yoga. So buddhi means intelligence, buddha means one who is intelligent. Nateshu ramate. Intelligent person will not enjoy in these things. Ramate means to enjoy. So therefore, to that word ramate, Srila Prabhupada cites a verse from Padma Purana, which actually describes why Lord Rama was given that name. Ramante yogino nante satyanande chidatmani iti rama padena sau param brahma vidiyate. Now ramante yoginaha anante. Yoginaha means the yogis. Ramante, they enjoy. What do they enjoy in? Where do they get their bliss in? In anante, in satyanande, in chidatmani. In these three things. Of course, these three are describing the same person. They are just adjectives. Chidatmani. Chidatmani means that Supreme Lord who is full of knowledge. Sat, Chit, Ananda. So Chit represents knowledge, the Chit Shakti. Consciousness also you could say. So Chidatmani, that Supreme Lord who is full of knowledge. And Satyanande. He is the source of true bliss. Krishna is the source of true bliss. And Ananta, he is unlimited. One of the names of the Lord is unlimited. So the yogis, they derive bliss in this person who is full of knowledge, who is the actual bliss personified, and who is unlimited. And therefore, and who is this person? This person is Parabrahma. Because Parabrahma has these attributes, iti rama asau iti rama padena abhidiyate. He is addressed with the word Rama. Because he has these attributes and in him the yogis find pleasure. And what are typically yogis doing? One of the meaning of yoga is yoga samadhau. Yoga means to be in samadhi. So the yogis are in samadhi. What are they doing in samadhi? They're meditating. Who are they meditating on? They're meditating on the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who has these attributes that we discussed. Therefore, and in that meditation, they're experiencing unlimited bliss. They're experiencing lot of bliss, lot of happiness. So therefore, he is called Rama. He is the source. So Krishna, Rama, he is the source of all bliss. By meditating on him, we get the bliss. What does that mean? That means he should be the object of our meditation for enjoyment. We can only enjoy when we are connected with him. And this is the important point. And Srila Prabhupada explains elsewhere that we are all parts and parcels of Krishna. Just like this finger can give me service. You know, if I have to take off my hat, put on my mask, play kartal, the desire is mine and the service is provided by this thing. Now as soon as these fingers are cut off from my hand, they have no value. They're useless. Similarly, a living entity, only when it is connected with Krishna, then the living entity attains its true value. And also proper enjoyment also. When it's connected with the body, then it remains healthy, it gets energy. That's how it survives. So similarly, when we are engaged in the service of Krishna, we derive energy, we derive bliss. And we also are in the proper Hindi situation, just like this hand is. So this is, and the experience, the happiness they are experiencing is so unlimited, and that is the reason they are able to give up the lower grades of happiness of this material world. Now we discussed the other temporary things that give us happiness. So now in the process of Krishna consciousness, we abstain from these things. And these are, this process of abstaining from material happiness, the Sanskrit word is tapas, tapa. The word tapa also means heat. Heat. Tapa means heat. And also the miseries, tapatrayam, the three miseries. So, but why do we want heat? Why do we want misery? We want dukkha yona evate, we want to avoid the miseries. Then again, why tapa? If tapa is something is not convenient, why do we need to take that one? Yes, go. It's better to suffer for a higher cause. Even to get something in the material world, even material enjoyment, we must undergo some endeavor. Nothing comes for free. Right? Just to get a job to make little money so that you can buy your own stuff. How long does it take? 16 years to get a bachelor's degree? Just to enjoy something. And kids, they wake up early, they study, they have before school, after school, and the school. So much hard work they have to do. All of that, for what purpose? I remember when I was a kid, you just go through this, then you can have fun. Just finish your 10th grade, just finish your 12th, just get through this entrance examination, just get your engineering, and just this, it never stops. And actually, I'm like, where is the enjoyment? I literally thought, you know, once I get to America, it's so much fun. I was disillusioned just within a few months. So it's just chasing, it never ends. Then why not do the same thing for something higher, which is going to last forever? We're all looking for something permanent. Some of us who have come from India may be looking for permanent visa, citizenship, you know, green card, and all these things for permanent situation. But we know nothing is permanent in this world. So therefore, Rishabhadeva, the word Srila Prabhupada is citing here, Nayam deho deha bhajam ruloke kashtan kaman arhate vidbhujam ye tapo divyam putra kayena sattvam shudye dhyasmad brahma saukyam tvanantam. Now, Rishabhadeva is suggesting, Nayam deha bhajam ruloke. We have acquired a deha. Deha means the body, material body. Rishabhadeva is teaching this to his sons. In the first canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, the incarnation of and the purpose of Rishabhadeva's appearance is described. Ashtame meru devyam tu naber jata urukramaha. Ashtame meru, in the eighth incarnation, the Lord has appeared in the womb of Merudevi through Nabhi, Urukramaha, the Lord who performs wonderful pastimes. Why did he come? Darshayan Vartma Dhiranam, Sarvashrama Namaskritam. Darshayan Vartma Dhiranam. In order to show the path of perfection. Vartma Darshayan. Now we have this word. Pradarshaka Guru, right? Or Vartma Pradarshaka Guru. Vartma Darsha. So what does that mean? What does it mean in English? Showing the path. Someone who distributes a book and says, you please come to the temple, and you come to the temple and you chant and you then get into the process. This person may not be giving shiksha and all those things, but he is the one who told you that there's a temple, please go there, he gave you a book. Vartma Pradarshaka, one who has shown you the Vartma, the path. So Rishabhadev, his incarnation is specifically for this purpose. Darshayan Vartma Dhiranam. He came to show the path of perfection, that path of Dhiras, who are self-controlled and who can follow this process that is going to describe the tapasya path. And Sarvashrama Namaskritam. And such highest path of perfection, that which is honored by all other ashramas. So which is the Paramahamsa ashrama, which is the to be in the state of Paramahamsa, like Srila Prabhupada, the highest quality of devotion, fully surrendered to the Lord. And he has come to show that path. And Rishabhadev is none other than Krishna himself. He is an incarnation of the Lord, Rishabhadev. So he is teaching to his sons. He had 100 sons. And the eldest of the sons was, does anyone know? Bharata Maharaj. And Bharata Maharaj, he ruled the planet Earth. And that's why India got its name Bharata Varsha. Bharata, it comes because he ruled the planet. Of course, there is also another version, son of Shakuntala, who is the ancestor of the Pandavas. Some say because of, he is also very popular and famous as well. But according to Srimad Bhagavatam, it is because of the Bharata Maharaj, son of Rishabhadev, that name has come. And we know the story of Bharata Maharaj also. So he is teaching to all his sons the path of perfection. And he's saying, my dear sons, there is no reason to labor very hard for sense pleasure while in this human form of life. Such pleasures are available to the stool eaters, hogs. Rather, you should undergo penances in this life by which your existence will be purified, and as a result you will be able to enjoy unlimited transcendental bliss. So sometimes it happens that we know that something is not good for us. Right? And even the government knows certain things are not good, but they still promote them. What are some of the things that are not good, but the government promotes?
Subsidy.
Subsidy of what? Alcohol and cigarettes. What is written on the pack of cigarette? Smoking is injurious to health. And you fool, if it is injurious, why are you even selling this to me? Right? Common sense. But they want money. They want money. And they sell it to us. So, and the person who is smoking also, he may know that he should not do it. But what happens? The body becomes like a machine. It just drags us over there. And of course, we may have experience of that in other things. You know you should be eating it, something. But, oh, this is good, just eat, let me eat it just for one day. And or you visit somebody and they feed you, please eat. And you feel obliged, yeah, it also tastes good, let me eat. And then later we suffer the misery. Now, what is the reason why we do something that we know we don't like to do? Right? Why? I kind of gave a hint, but why do we do that? Yes, parsha. And there's something dragging us, right? There's something dragging us to it. So this is called impure consciousness. And our consciousness is impure. Then the senses take control of us and they drag us to different places. I mean, there's a whole hierarchy of how things happen. I'm not going to get into it. But simpler version is the consciousness is impure. Now, when the consciousness is purified, then we will be able to do things that we really want to do. I mean, even materially, we may have so many ways of doing things. You know, I'm going to get up and rake my leaves and do this and do that. Then we just sit in front of the computer and the whole day passes, goes by. Oh, again, one more day. One more day is lost. Or I'm going to write this paper in school. Or I'm going to study these verses. And the clock keeps ticking, and oops, the last day, then we stay up night, you know, at night. We don't do it. So we want to do it, but we cannot. So there's something in between the true desire of the soul and the actually doing that act. So in between, there is these layers of impure consciousness. Now, we need to be purified. And that purification happens through the process of tapasya, like Rishabhadeva is saying here. Shuddhyet yasmat brahma saukhyam tvanantam. By the process of tapasya, shuddhi, the purification happens. When the purification happens, then it lights up. Now, we may have a service to wash the pots. Pot is looking ugly, but you keep on washing, eventually it shines. Or even, you know, scrubbing the floors, right? So that process brings out that illumination of the soul. But what is that process? There are many different, you know, ways of doing tapasyas also. But the highest tapasya is simply taking up the process of Krishna consciousness and following the prescriptions given in the process of Krishna consciousness. The goal of tapasya is to get connected to Krishna. Aradito yadi hari tapasata takkim. Naradito yadi hari tapasata takkim. If you are worshipping Krishna, then what is the use of tapasyas? You're already worshipping Krishna. If you are not worshipping Krishna, then what is the use of your tapasyas? Because they haven't led you to worshipping Krishna. So therefore, tapasya is meant for coming to the point of Krishna consciousness. That's the Brahma Saukhyam. That's the true Brahma Saukhyam. In the verse previously that we read, when the consciousness is directed toward Rama, then the Brahma Saukhyam will come. When we are engaged in the service of Lord Ramachandra, when we are engaged in the service of Krishna, then the true happiness will come. Otherwise, okay, we can stay away from the miseries of the material world, but we will not experience the happiness, the true spiritual happiness. It will be like this. It gets dark so early. So we go out, we buy something, and we're coming home. And on that day, there's nobody in the streets, so quiet. So you go to shop, buy something, and you're walking to your house. And you have to, you know, take 3-4 turns, 3-4 streets to get to your home. So we are walking and walking. So you pass one street, and it's dark, and there's no one. But then you hear this sound, a couple of guys are just walking behind you. And you're suspicious something is wrong. And you kind of look back, and you know they're carrying some weapons and they're trying to come rob you. And then you detect that and you start running and running and running, and they're chasing you, you're running. And then finally you find one open door, you just go there and shut the door behind you. Now on the streets there was a little bit light and you're able to see. And now when these people coming at you to chase, and then you turn around and you get into the door, and they're outside, where did this guy go, where did he go? They're looking for you, but you're inside. And then you're feeling, oh, wow, I escaped this thing. I escaped. You know, because they didn't figure out which door you went through. You turn and then you hid yourself. It seems they disappeared. So you're still, your eyes are closed, and you sat down and your heart is beating. And then you open your eyes. The room is pitch dark. Now what do you do? 1 minute, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, right? So the happiness was in escaping the misery, but one sitting in the dark room, what am I going to do now here? So the tapasyas for impersonal liberation, just to get out of this material world, but then you have nothing to do. It's boring for the spirit soul. Therefore, the spirit soul comes back to this material world. Aruhya kruchena parampadam patantyadaha anadrita yushmadangraya. Because of lack of devotion to the lotus feet of the Lord, then the spirit soul cannot stay there forever. Okay, I escaped from those guys, but now I'm scared to go back. But it's so boring inside. sitting in this room, in a dark room. What am I going to do? So therefore it's not just, you know, intelligent person figures out that this material world is bad, it leads to suffering. But the nature of the soul is to be happy. Satchidananda. We cannot be inactive even for a moment. It's not possible. It's impossible. Our mind is constantly thinking about things. So therefore, we need something higher. And this is described as Param Drishti. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita that Param Drishtva Nivartate. How does that word start? Vishaya Vinivartante Niraharasya Dehinaha Rasavarjam Rasopyasya Param Drishtva Nivartate. Okay, we can abstain. The senses can abstain from the sense object. But the taste, but the desire for enjoyment still remains. So therefore, it is better to give up the lower taste by engaging in higher taste. And that higher taste is the process of Krishna consciousness. Yes, it is tapasya to get up in the morning at 4 a.m. Srila Prabhupada says we require everybody in the process, in the movement of Krishna consciousness, we require everyone to rise early by 4 a.m. and engage in Mangalarati, in reading Srimad Bhagavatam, in worshipping the deity, in honoring prasadam, in all these activities. Now it is really only tapasya until we get up and get into the shower. So my daughter was telling me, now in order to chant Gayatri, you have to take bath. Sometimes she's taking bath three times. And she told me that it's actually until you get into the shower, it's tapasya. But once you get in the shower, it's nice. You feel good. And actually, if you feel even tired and lazy, if you get a shower, it feels so good. So really, that tapasya is to just push out us out of the bed in the morning. And then later we feel so happy to participate in the Mangalarati. And those of you come here and, you know, go and just be with the deities, it's so much bliss. So much bliss to be offering aarti, to look at the deities in the morning, to smell the wonderful fragrance. It just shoots up the consciousness. That it penetrates through that consciousness that Rishabhadeva is saying, Shuddhet yasmat brahma saukhyam tvanantam. That shuddhi, that purification is happening right away. Just by hearing the kirtan, by looking at the deities, by smelling the wonderful aroma that pervades this beautiful temple, everything is gone. And is it tapasya to be vegetarian? Is it tapasya to not eat meat? In the beginning it may look like, but later, like, oh my gosh, was I eating this crap which smells so bad? One time devotees, they went on Harinam. Badrinarayan has told me this story. And they went on Harinam. And then all of a sudden, they were just lifting their shoes and seeing if they stepped on something because it's stinking so bad. Like, you know, did I say step on something? What is this smell? And then they realized they were next to, you know, some kind of meat restaurant. That's where it's coming from. They're like, oh, we used to do this? Right? And you realize that. That what we thought that we were enjoying was actually so disgusting at a later time. When our consciousness is purified, we can see that this is bad. And imagine, we are thinking that what the hog is eating is bad. But for hog, it's not bad. But when the consciousness is purified, then we know that, oh, that's bad. So similarly, once we taste the beauty of Krishna consciousness, this material pleasure is insignificant, and actually it feels very disgusting even thinking about that. But the only way we can, you know, stay in that higher consciousness is by continuous association of devotees. It has to be done continuously. Otherwise we fall sick. We have to take the medicine regularly. What happens if you don't take the medicine? Then the problem will come back. What happens if you don't exercise? The back problem will come back. If you don't exercise for you don't go on a walk, just sit in front of the computer, then the body starts giving problems. So therefore, for anything, constant practice is required. Similarly, for spiritual matters. One time one person asked His Holiness Radhanath Maharaj, I feel good when I come to temple. It feels so nice. But why don't I feel the same thing, you know, later when I go home and I don't feel like doing anything? Then Radhanath Swami asked him, how many times a day do you eat? So 3 times. Then how many times you come to the temple? You know, so once a month or something like that. He said, if you're eating 3 times so that you get energy, right? So you have to continuously eat, you know, eat regularly. Similarly, we have to regularly associate with devotees. We have to regularly come to temple. We have to regularly practice Krishna consciousness. Then we stay healthy. Then we stay in this higher consciousness all the time. So this is the content. In order to become true yogi, we don't engage in the bhoga that comes from samsparja. Yehi samsparshaja bhoga. And because it's dukkha yoni, it is the source of misery, it's the mother place, it is the mother of miseries. Material enjoyment is the mother of miseries. Because every material enjoyment produces misery at a later time. It may not be immediate, but if we enjoyed something for our own pleasure, it's guaranteed that misery is coming at some point of time. Yeah, so with that, I'll stop. We have about 5 minutes. If anyone has any questions or comments.
Yes, Prabhu.
Yeah. yeah, it's a good question. You can actually, in the beginning stages, you can. So if you go to Patanjali Yoga Sutras, Patanjali Muni suggests performing yoga, and that yoga, he suggests you meditate, you can meditate on your spiritual master. Lord Shiva is like a spiritual master. And he says you can even meditate on any object. Now this is the popular yoga that's out there. Is there, you think of a lotus, you think of a candle. But then he says, Ishvara Pranidhanat Samadhi Siddhi, the Yoga Sutras later, if you want to get perfection in Samadhi, you must perform Ishvara Pranidhana, which is devotion to Krishna. And he describes Ishvara. And that Ishvara is a Vishesha Purusha, who is beyond the three modes of material nature. And the description of Ishvara he gives only fits, only Krishna fits the bill. It is described in the Bhagavad Gita. So therefore, for the success, you must meditate on Krishna. Therefore, that's why Krishna says, Yoginam api sarvesham madgate nantaratmana shraddhavan bhajate yomam same tamo yuktam same tamo. What does it go, last line? Same yukta tamo mataha. So he's saying that person is the highest of all the yogis, one who meditates on me. So other yogis may be meditating on something else, but they are not the topmost. If you want the topmost, better meditate on Krishna. The perfection of samadhi comes only when the meditation happens on Krishna. So good question. Thank you. What? I'm sorry, I couldn't hear properly. Oh, okay. Yeah, we are cheating. I set him up so that I can answer and feel. Oh, Sugopi knew what my class was. No, she didn't, but she said one thing. She said one thing, I think in the class today you are going to say yoga chitta vritti nirodha. So I was trying not to say that sentence because she you know, teases me that whenever the subject of yoga comes, I quote, that is the very first verse in the Patanjali Yoga Sutras, yoga chitta vritti nirodha. So I didn't quote that today. You are saying something, Mataji? Malti Priya Mataji?
No, I said by saying that you go to...
Yes. Yeah. Yes, Prabhu. We can be. What I meant to say is that laziness, you know, that difficulty, you know, feeling like, oh, I don't want to get up. So whatever that you feel, the difficulty, or even the mental laziness, but once you get in the shower, you feel good. It goes away. It gets driven away. So what I'm saying is, if you just that little bit of trouble, if you take only that part, so the tapasya, I said the meaning was, is something that's heat, something that feels difficult to do, something that feels like, oh, I have to sacrifice something, right? So that feeling is there only until you get there. But once you get your shower and everything, you feel so good that you have done it. So that starting trouble is, I'm saying, that few minutes is the only problem. That's all I'm saying. So you can, if you are able to tolerate that much, then you're done. Even if you take cold shower, right, it's just the first couple of mugs that gives you problem, and then later, you know, once you get out, you feel good. Yeah. You can wake up at 4 and still be asleep. That's why we need association of devotees. Yeah, that's why take a shower and be in the association of devotees, right? You know, when we do it, then it's really, really good. Yeah. So I think it's time now. Yes.
Like in order to control the senses, they say that you don't identify with the sense objects. Could you explain the process?
Yeah. So when we come to this knowledge that I am not this body. Of course, this is, we keep on hearing this again and again, it's not easy. So that knowledge, jnana, knowledge helps us to distinguish that, okay, this is going to put me in suffering, right? And that is helpful. Knowledge is helpful to give vairagya. From jnana, vairagya takes birth. From knowledge, renunciation takes birth. But the problem is, it doesn't give us enough strength to still restrain. Therefore, even though I don't want to do, I get pushed into it. I know it's not good for me and I do it again. So that means there's something else is lacking. So therefore, higher than knowledge, just knowledge, is devotion. So the constant engagement in devotion will give us so much strength that it will give us power to stay away from it. And that devotion has given us the higher taste, and it's very easy to give up the lower taste when we properly experience the higher taste, the process of devotion. So the beginning step is knowledge to discern what's good for me and what's not good for me. And in order to continue on the path of knowledge and get strength, association of devotees and gaining the devotional strength. So that's what helps. Okay, so thank you very much, all of you, for your kind association and participation. Srimad Bhagavad Gita ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Samaveda Bhaktavinoda ki jai.
प्रभु है और वो नहीं करेंगे जय श्री जगन्नाथ बलदेव सुभद्रा माई की जगन्नाथ बलदेव सुभद्रा मैया की
जय।
श्री गौर निताय की जय। जय गौराचंदे आरती कशोभा।
मधुर बाजे राम बाजे गांडा
देशतारिणे नामते तारक Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna.
Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Rama Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, 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 Hare Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Hare Hare, yeah.
Jai Jagannatha, 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 Jai Jagannat Jai Om Vishnu Pad Paramahansa Parabraja Kachara Jasata Sata Shri Shri Manita Vangris Shila Bhakti Siddhanta Sarasati Guru Swami Maharaj Shila Prabhupada Ki Jai Ananta Koti Vaishnava Namacharya Shila Haridas Thakur Ki Jai Principal Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Adaita Ganadha Shri Vasudi Gaura Bhakta Vinay Ki Jai Shri Shri Radha Krishna Prabhu Gopinath Shambhava Dharani
Thank you. Prahlad ki.
Jai.
And the Koti Vaishnavinda ki.
Jai.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you very much, everybody, for coming to our Sunday this evening. We have one big sponsor, Naveen Patel and family. Hari.
Hari Bo.
If anyone else is interested in sponsoring, you can be one of our Sunday sponsors for only $125. For that, you may contact us with our Mahaprabhuji or our Grace Ramadhi. Is there anyone who is visiting an ISKCON center for the first time? We usually have a special gift for first time visitors. We have our regular visitors today.
It's always the first time.
Sorry,
Krishna.
Tuesday, November 30th, is Ekadashi. Haribo!
Haribo!
It is recommended for those of us who can to fast on grains, beans, peas, legumes on that day. Engage in more spiritual activities, like reading more of Srila Prabhupada's books, chanting more rounds of the Hare Krishna Mahamantra, and but it is recommended that you try and do it as early as possible, starting at 8 o'clock. Facebook would match that donation, either fully or partially, and for any further details, you can also contact Ganapati Govind Prabhuji. Next Sunday, we have a special guest with us. We'll be having His Holiness Ruma Padaswami Maharaj.
Haribo!
So we intend to look forward to that Sunday class next Sunday. Gita Nagarimut is already here.
Yes.
So, all devotees who have subscribed for Gita Nagarimut, please make sure before you leave you can collect your new books from Nanda Bhattu. And with that, now we have more chanting for our friend sponsor. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Krishna.
Thank you.
Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama.
Jaya Prabhupada, Prabhupada, Prabhupada. श्री श्री हरिनाम संकीर्तन की।